Time for round two. See if we can get a turn on one drop. No, but I think this hand is a reasonable keep on the play, since I've got some good three drops here. I'm not sure which one I'm going to lead with, since it is nice to disrupt them with click and then play Shadow Mage when there's no answers to it, but if I'm playing against a color combination like, let's say, white-green or something, where they don't have too many answers to Shadow Mage, I'd rather just run that out first. Alright, and I guess I'll lead with... I think I'm going to lead with Swamp. I want to be able to cast Night Veil Spectre on 3 if that is required of me, and I don't want to play a non-basic first. And I don't want to play a Polluted Delta first, because if I draw Brainstorm, the longer I wait till I play and crack Polluted Delta, the better. Well, also Swamp kind of is a little bit of deception, since this is not really a black deck in any sense of the word. Alright, playing against a green deck. Let's see if my opponent's won with the one drop. Hopefully not, since this hand's a little slow, and if my opponent opens with a one drop, that could be slightly problematic for me. Against Forest, I'm inclined to just play Shadow Mage, since not a whole lot of answers to it. Alright, let's see what my opponent is up to. Nothing on turn one. I do land. I guess I could play into Wasteland here. I think it's worth playing, you know, with the risk of Wasteland. If it plus my opponent Wastelands, it's just a time walk for both of us. Because this way I can play Vendilion next turn. Ooh, now that, wish I'd drawn that earlier. Now that my opponent has Island out, I'm slightly more inclined to want to just play Delta and draw step Vendilion my opponent here. Alright, just go for it. Get an island and play a Vendilion click. Don't stop my opponent's draw step. Let's see what we got. Oh, this is the person who took the Mystic Snake. And I'm glad I did this, since I'm probably going to have to take Show and Tell here. It's a ramp deck. So I take Show and Tell, otherwise Ulamog's coming down right now. And I could also take Ulamog. That actually might make more sense. Because my opponent does a Heartbeat, Playdemir, Solemn. Yeah, so I'm going to take Ulamog, leaving my opponent with a bunch of Mana Ramp and a Mystic Snake. I guess I'm glad I played Vendilion Click there rather than just playing Shadow Mage. And so my opponent's going to play like a Playdemir here, potentially. Seems like a play that makes sense with Solemn, Mystic Snake, Heartbeat. A lot of action there. And I'm going to probably just play the Shadow Mage Infiltrator, though... doesn't actually get by Palladium. Ooh, Lotus Cobra. I can play that first. Alright, Lotus Cobra. Play land. Let's add a black. Play Shadow Mage. This at least forces my opponent to keep Palladium untapped. Unless my opponent wants to get hit by Shadow Mage Infiltrator. But it's going to have a lot of mana. So hopefully not find anything incredibly insane to do with that mana. So still looking at, yeah, Show and Tell, Mystic Snake, Solemn. And Heartbeat of Spring all waiting in hand here. I have to say, my deck cannot really make use of Heartbeat or Show and Tell in a particularly impressive fashion. I'm probably going to drop Baleful Strix next turn and hope to get a hit with Shadow Mage. Though if my opponent plays a Solemn Simulacrum, then I guess I'm not Shadow Maging either. So Vendilion Click, you got to do some work. And my opponent's going to have Mystic Snake up pretty soon here, which is kind of unfortunate for me. Unless they drew something to Show and Tell in. That could be bad. You can play Heartbeat off Palladium Mirror. Is that the plan? Yep, we're going nuts here. Alright. Let's see how this ends up, since, again, my hand's pretty empty. So, I wonder if I can set in random stuff to take advantage of Heartbeat and Show and Tell. Alright, going with the Solemn. And most likely my turn here. Draw. Boo. Alright. Let's play Baleful Strix. I can have a million mana with Lotus Cobra, Windswept Teeth, and Heartbeat of Spring. Not a whole lot to do with it, but Night Veil Spectre is at least good. Let's play for blue, blue, blue. Let's just play a normal land and save the Windswept Teeth for now. And let's hit... I could sack Lotus Cobra to draw a card here. Since I could attack with Lotus Cobra and Shadow Mage. Then my opponent gets to draw a card off Solemn, so I don't love that. I feel like my opponent's cards are a lot more dangerous than mine. Alright, Mystic Snake means I can't really successfully resolve much, though if next turn I get to hit with Night Veil and take Ulamog, that would be awesome. You know how likely that is? Looks like my opponent drew Something insane. Genesis wave? No, tooth and nail. Alright. I mean, I can't stop that from happening, so let's hope I don't die immediately. Ulamog, I can at least block with Baleful Strix. If that's number one. Oh, and Palancron. Okay, you have infinite mana now. I guess that's cool. Well, actually, no, it's not quite enough to go infinite. It just lets my opponent untap all the lands and attack with a... Oh, I see. Play Ulamog. Yeah. Alright. Opponent's deck looks pretty cool here, so... Unfortunately, I don't have a ton that can disrupt it. I'm not going to complain more about needing opposition, but... could use it. Alright, so Ulamog comes down. Let's see what it kills. My guess is Baleful Strix, but... That might not be the case. It's in Night Vale Spectre. Well, that's fine. I wasn't going to get hit with that anyway. So my opponent does have infinite mana once they draw another land. Because then you can return Palancron, play it untapped seven lands, or six lands in this case, and go off. Alright. Yeah, I am ready to be done with this game. My opponent's got a Mystic Snake to counter my next good play also, so... Alright, what can I side in? I could side in Deathcloud. It sounds a little weird, but if my opponent goes off with, or like casts Heartbeat, I can just cast a giant Deathcloud in response. That could be kind of cool. I could just run it off the Urborg or Coalition Relic, or Heartbeat plus my black lands. That seems kind of sweet. I mean, the thing is, like, otherwise, like, I'm relying on like Traitor Rider. Or all these other things. Though actually, I guess I have Plowunder, Trigon Predator. Actually, I'm not in such bad shape that I have to do that, I don't think. And nothing else here seems all that great. I mean, Rude Awakening is cool if I have a million mana, but I still don't get to attack with that many lands. I attack with like five lands or something. So I'm just going to rely on my good disruptive creatures and hope that gets there.